Nature throws immense possibilities to display and deploy creativity. The beauty all around us, to see, touch, and hear. It is miraculous because it's always changing. And the changes are sensory, intrinsic. The principle of nature is clear. It's selfless, inspiring, imaginative, open, dedicated, and untiring. Nature is a giver, a provider, an imparter. Very few understand, accept, inculcate, and follow these principles. Professor Ganpati Dada Sahib Yadav, popularly known as Professor G.D. Yadav, is one amongst those few. Born on the 14th of September, 1952, in a peasant's family from which hail several renowned wrestlers, comes as no surprise that Professor G.D. Yadav himself used to wrestle as a child. Dwelling in a small village, Arjunwada, located in Kolhapur district, Maharashtra. He was educated till grade 7 in the primary school of his village.
I remember my childhood when I used to climb up the tree with a book in my hand and sit there and study. And in fact, many of my classmates also did the same thing. Not only that, you know, I remember this particular river and this ghat since the age of about 8, maybe, you know, I've been coming to this place to take my bath early in the morning. So this would be around 4 o'clock in the morning. And I used to take bath and take a pot of water and go back and then do my, puja and then do studies. In fact, we did not have any lights then, no electricity. So it was the lantern which we used to use.
His teachers made use of village temples as classrooms. By the time he entered the 7th standard, there were only 5 teachers. He ranked first in the entire district.
Ek talak buddhi cha vidyarthi, ek pati vidyarthi, ek vel vachla ki punna tyana vachayla lagayche nahi. आणि पुस्तक हातात घेतलं की ते संपूर्ण धडे वाचून होईपर्यंत त्यांचं दुसरीकडे लक्ष नसायचं.
After the 7th standard, he had to enroll himself in a secondary school in Shelewadi, a neighboring village which was 5 kilometers away. And the to and fro daily journey here entailed walking bare feet. Having reckoned his radiance and thereby the need to be amidst true scholars, to migrate cityward at the earliest was the advice dispensed to Ganpati's parents by Mr. Bal Ganga Tirthakar.
Bal Ganga Tirthakar used to teach me English also. So towards the end of the year, he said that I should not stay in that village for my further education. I should go to the city, and private high school is the best high school in Kolhapur. And he will tell his father, and because I was number one student, I will get admission without any problem. So that is how I went to Kolhapur.
Akalan Shanti Dabarasas Anavadhanani Kontahi Jari Prashna Vicharla Tadetita Achuk Uttar Denamudhata Attenta Takpar Hota.
Ganpati left his home at the tender age of 14 to continue his studies at the elite private high school in the city of Kolhapur. He remained the top performing student.
Tanche science ani physics chemistry che marks 92 ani 96 mala paath ahet. माझ्या माहितीनुसार इंग्रजीला यादवना त्यावेळी 80 मार्क होते आणि संस्कृतमध्ये 84. म्हणजे या दोन विषयामध्ये त्यावेळी ते टॉपरच होते आमच्या हायस्कूलमध्ये.
after 11 years of schooling in Marathi medium, up to SSC. He joined Rajaram College at Kolhapur in 1968 for his pre-degree and inter-science pre-professional programs. Ganpati chose to join UDCT for the Bachelor of Chemical Engineering program, which was of 4 years.
I came and I just gave my form, which was 1 rupee, and I had all the attested copies of my certificate. So the gentleman who was sitting here, he said, today is the last date. Luckily you have come. And it was around 4:30 or so. And he said, today we are closing, but I can tell you, we have prepared the merit list. And according to your marks and all, you are number 9 in the All India merit list. And you will get admission. And I just left. I had not still thought of UDCT. I went home and within a week, I got a telegram. And that said, sir, you have been admitted to BKM Engineering course of, and a seat has been reserved for in the hostel.
He was fascinated by his teacher, Professor M.M. Sharma, who remained his guru all his life.
I saw him more closely when he became my research student in 74. And I could see how hardworking, how intelligent he was. Most important, a multifarious personality. I mean, he was good in theory, good in experiments, good in making sketches. I didn't know at that time that he also has traits of being a poet, and that he is good in Sanskrit, and that he can write in Marathi poems and all. I didn't know that at that time.
So nature has taught me many things. I became poet because of that. I used to write very good Marathi literature, English literature, because of my association with nature.
But I did know, in fact, for my book, which was under preparation, he prepared many, many diagrams. He was also what we used to call demonstrator, which were redesignated as associate lecturer. So running the lab, he had flair for doing experiments. And in fact, he pioneered the work first time in India, although it was more organic chemistry oriented. No organic chemist in India had taken up that work. And he took up that work on my advice. And not only it was published in good journal, it was also commercialized.
Later on, he went to Loughborough University in the United Kingdom as a visiting fellow and worked on oil blob mechanics in porous media. Further, he went on to join the group of F.A.L. Darling at the University of Waterloo till 1986. On Professor M.M. Sharma's advice, he returned to India in 1986 and joined as a reader in chemical engineering at the UDCT, Mumbai. He brought significant and sustainable changes through research. He continued to work in oil recovery methods with support from the Oil and Natural Gas Corporation, that is ONGC, which has been patented, and also studied coal structure and gasification, fractals and catalysis. He also started consulting with the renowned chemical industries. He received a large number of research grants and has maintained a very active research group since 1990.
Through catalytic processes, he has selected systems properly. And this might have come partly out of exposure to me and my collaborator. Because our mission was always pick up a topic of great academic interest so that you impart proper training. At the same time, it should be capable of being taken to industry.
Professor Dr. Ganpati Dadasaheb Yadav, Vigyan M.M. Engineering.
Dr. Yadav has received numerous honors and distinctions for his innovative contributions to green chemistry and engineering, catalysis science and engineering, chemical reaction engineering, biotechnology, nanotechnology, and energy engineering.
Some of the worst disasters have taken place in India. And therefore, green chemistry, green engineering, green technology becomes extremely important. And Dr. Yadav's one of the greatest contributions has been his contribution to green chemistry and green technology through a variety of innovative things that he has done, including his novel catalytic processes, etc., etc., you know.
The hallmark of his research is its fundamental analysis with a focus on industrial adoption and commercialization.
I think a lot of work which has been done by him has been recognized not only in academic also, but has a lot of industrial application also. He has done phenomenal work in catalysis, phase transfer catalysis. And I think overall more than 60 patents he has. And green technology, pollution free technology, a lot of technology has been developed. And quite a few of them is already used in industry also. So he has always tried to see that, you know, his research has also used in the real situation in industry.
Under his leadership, ICT became stronger, effective, viable and visible, and relevant to solve problems of today.
Professor G.D. Yadav, starting from his very humble background in rural India, has risen to where he is today, is a testimony to that philosophy of Dhirubhai uncle and his attention to the details in his execution and his passion always reminds me of his comparison with the great people. He has taken pains to foster the legacy of Professor M.M. Sharma, Dr. Mashelkar and the likes, and without his personal efforts, the name UDCT would not have been proudly changed to ICT. So I deeply commend his efforts there.
ICT is a prominent landmark in Mumbai, a renowned institute with its magnificent and palatial buildings, spacious campus, high-quality infrastructure, and well-earned reputation for its academic excellence.
Professor Yadav, of course, has been very active. He is very positive in his thinking, so he has a knack of getting people to do research work at UDCT, to give donations to UDCT, this is from past rooms as well as institutions and all, you know. So, and he's doing a great job in that.
It's a modern day Gurukul. ICT has a great heritage. It has resources. It has vigor and elasticity of growth.
Thing, but I must in due modesty say that there was a very, very strong foundation by my predecessors, by faculty,
by students, by alumni, including the support staff. They work, you know, some of them are not recognized, but they are behind us. And I think that is what is responsible for this. And we are open about everything. You know, it's not that my faculty members get the maximum freedom they would have ever imagined it.
We have a very great equation based on trust, basically. You ask him anything that he sends me for approval, he gets shocked if I have not returned it within 10 minutes, basically. You know, if I'm traveling, etc., that happens. So my implicit trust in him is so much that we don't have any bureaucratic relationship like a chancellor and a vice chancellor. We are more like a family. We are more like friends, if you like. All right. So he's not my subordinate. He's my colleague.
Dr. Yadav is a very popular teacher who insists on discipline. He had a method and knack of his own. His ability as a teacher stands unchallenged. Dr. G.D. Yadav is a confident scientist, a scholarly person, an educator. At the same time, he is very much at ease with his school friends and village folks. He balances to such contrast and diverse situations and diverse people comfortably. On the family front, he has been a supportive husband and a loving father. Wife, Vasanti, is a PhD in chemical technology and has her own business. Sons, Vikramaditya and Gautam, are both chemical engineers. Manali, his daughter-in-law, is an architect.
You are a tireless individual who never accepts defeat. You're always full of life, you're vivacious, and your smile is quite energizing. And it is unsurprising that you've been such a productive researcher, because an integral part of research is to get your team at the same levels of energy and enthusiasm as yourself.
Even though I was a new entrant to the family, Daddy has always treated me like his daughter. So if I have any questions or if I have any problem related to personal or professional life, Daddy is always there. He's like my guru, like my mentor.
The latest addition to the family is Dr. G.D. Yadav's grandson, Arun.
He is an excellent engineer. He can repair, he can do everything. You know, you want to fix a door, he will fix a door. You want to do anything, he's a good carpenter, he's a good mechanic, he's a, sometimes it is so easy for him. He will do everything in the house also. Fixing a nail, fixing anything, he's a fantastic engineer also.
I remember he used to teach us languages, not science, which is kind of ironic since I'm in a science field. For him, it was more about learning the language of communication and delivering our thoughts and ideas. That's what really mattered, instead of delivering or talking about science. Talking about science, you need language, and that's the first thing that he really instilled in us. And I think it's an important thing that he's passed on to us. And as an inspiration, it's very humbling to see that a person from a village background could reach this position. And that's always served as an inspiration to our family.
He is a kind-hearted person. He will help everybody from all because of his background. He has come, especially he has a very, very soft corner for students, those who are coming from a village background or from that. He feels that, you know, if a student is from city, he already has lot of advantage. But if a village student is there, we have to help him.
you can create your own place in this society. If you have merit, if you are hardworking, you are devoted, you follow the righteous path, dharma is righteous path, okay? You can always be a winner, but you should never give up.